Good morning. Today we'll discuss about the queue structure. In this topic, we'll be discussing about introduction to queues, then the queue ADT, the queue data, abstract data type. Then we'll also explain how to implement queue using arrays. First of all, queue is a first-in, first-out structure. The first entry that is going into the queue will be the first entry will go out of the queue. The queue data structure is one of the most popular data structure. Why? Because you can always find queue in many places. For example, let's say a queue of people standing one by one, so that some service, let's say you have a desk here to get some service, so there are some n number of queues. This is the first person who came into the queue. This is the second person, and the service will be available to the first person. Only after that, the second person will get serviced, and so on. You guys find queues in many places, like while executing so many programs, so many processes, your CPU will take all these processors in a queue, and it will process one by one. While attending a phone call, if you receive another phone call, you will get a message that you are in queue. So if you're trying to implement any one of these situations where such a first in first out structure is followed, first in first out format is followed, then you can implement the same using a queue. In a queue, we can see that there are operations like addition onto the queue and addition from the queue. So a new person will come into this queue, a new person will come and here. The first person that is going out of the queue will be from here. So in general sense, we say that this is the front of the queue and this is the rear end of the queue. So usually people, or usually the element, get added at the rear end of the queue, and an element will be deleted, or the element will be, or the item will be served from the front end of the queue. So let's discuss about the abstract data type, QADT. As we have seen in the case of stacks, we'll also discuss ADT, QADT as two entries. One is the data and the second is the operations. The data that is required is two pointers, a front pointer and a rear pointer. Front pointer is for deleting an element from the queue, and a rear pointer is for adding an element onto the queue. Then of course we need space for storing elements. For example, this is a queue of size 6. This is the zeroth and the zeroth element in the queue, first element, second element, so on. So here you can have, you can store 6 elements. So this is a queue of 6 elements. So you always, along with a queue data structure, you should have a size parameter which specifies how much space need to be used for storing that number of elements. So data and a queue ADT will have to specify how much space is required for storing the elements and what is the present condition front and rear pointer. You have operations, the basic operations or the main operations in queue data structure is NQ operation and DQ operation. This is same as insert element onto or addition of element onto the queue, and DQ is deletion of element. So of course, as we have seen, addition will be done at the rear end of the queue and deletion will be done at the front end of the queue. So NQ is addition, Q is deletion. Then there can be operation like is empty, is full, what is the first element, what is the last element, and that sort of operations can be there. Is empty is going to return 0 if the queue is not empty. Is empty is going to return 1 if the queue is empty. So it can return a value 1 or 0. If the queue is empty, it will return 1, otherwise 0. The same is this operation is also is going to give the same thing. Queue can be implemented by using arrays or any other concrete data structures which uses this linear representation of elements. So for example, you would like to create a queue of 6 integers. What you can do is you can create an array of 6 integers and you can implement a queue. Queue can also be implemented by using linked list. We'll be learning list implementation later. Today we'll try to implement queue data structure using array. So we have been talking about queue as is having pointers, a front pointer and a rear pointer. Let's take it to some more simpler, like a queue having only a single pointer. So this is queue can be implemented by using in many different methods. We'll take two methods. First method is by using a single pointer. So what I'm trying to say is we don't have two pointers like front and rear pointer. We have only one pointer. Like a stack, we have only one pointer, but still we try to implement this structure, what is known as the first in, first out structure. So here what we need to do is we need to implement this first in, first out. What we have is an array of elements, so these elements are arranged in a sequential manner because it's an array. But what we need to implement is this first in first out structure. The element that has gone in first should be taken out first. We have two operations. One is an NQ operation. Another one is a DQ operation. You say NQ operation, the element get added. You say DQ operation, the element, the first element that has come into this should get removed from the queue. Another implementation what we'll see is a normal queue implementation by using a two pointers, front and rear pointer. We will see what is the drawback by using a single pointer, and we'll come to using two pointers, front and rear pointer. And later we'll discuss about the drawbacks of queue using arrays. And let's see how we can overcome that, the drawbacks, and how we can modify our structure so that some of the drawbacks can be avoided. Say you have a queue of size 7 implemented as an array. So as told, you have an array of size 7 running through 0 to 6. So index equal to 0, you have one element. Index 1, you can store another element, and so on. The size of the array is 7. Means that you have a queue of 7. I'm trying to implement the queue using one pointer, one variable, a rear pointer only. I'm storing one rear variable. Initially, the queue is pointing to, the rear is pointing to a value minus 1, means that there is no element in the queue. The queue is M. So a rear pointer is pointing here, minus 1. Now, if you add one element, what will happen is, you have insert some of the elements, you called NQ operation. So this was your queue. Now you have added some of the elements. The first initially it was pointing to minus one. You have added one element, the rear will be pointing to the first element. You have added the second element, the rear again, the rear will be updated to point to the next element, and so on. Now the rear is pointing this element. Sorry. Now the rear is pointing to value. Sorry, now the this should be right. So now the rear is pointing to the last element, because then only if you have if you try to insert one more element x, then you can insert it here. Okay, so now we have only one pointer, which we have an array and one pointer rear, which is used for inserting an element. So the insert operation, how much time it is consuming? Every time you insert an element, the rear you place that, for example, at point of time you insert one more element x, what will happen is x will be inserted here. Previous pointer was pointing here, fifth position. Now you insert one more element, it will get inserted here and update this rear pointer. So there is no looping statement at all, just update this rear pointer, insert the element, that's it. So it's a constant time operation. It's also called an order of one operation. So insert operation in the case of queue using array and with only single pointer, with single rear pointer, it's a constant operation, insert operation. Let's see what will happen in the case of, let's see the implementation using a single rear pointer, and we have discovered the NQ operation. Now let's see the DQ operation. So what we know is the first element that has gone into the queue is 5. So a DQ operation, a deletion from the queue, this element need to be removed. So this should be the structure. 5 need to be removed, and this element need to be copied to this position. Then the second element need to be copied to this position. Third element need to be copied to this position, and so on. So previously the rear was pointing here. Rear was pointing here 5. Now we have elements only up to 4. So the rear also need to be taken back to this position. So now rear should be 4. So you remove the first element or Q of 0, you have an array Q. So Q of 0 need to be removed. That is your first element. Q of 0 is removed. Now Q of 1 is taken to Q of 0's position. Q 2 is taken to Q of 1's position, and so on. So you need to copy each of the elements to its previous position, so that the entire array, wherever there are elements, you need to copy the number of elements to one position back, so that 7 here, 15 will be here, and so on. So this will be the new queue structure. And of course you need to change the rear pointer as well. You need to change the rear pointer one position back, so it is the rear is 5 minus 1, previous rear value minus 1. That's it. You have removed one element, means that you have updated. Now, what is the cost of this operation? How much time this operation is going to consume? We have seen that an NQ operation or insert operation was going to take, you was taking only constant time. It is just updating a rear pointer, inserting that element here. But here, for deleting one item, you have to copy each item back one position back, so that you will have to have so many copy statements. How many number of copy statements you can calculate that? The number of copy statements that you need to execute is related to the number elements that is there in your array. So we say that it is order of n. It is related to the number of elements in the array. That is what that n. We'll discussing about this order of one, order of n, or the time complexity, and how to calculate the time complexity, space complexity of an algorithm or a program in a later class. This is by using two pointers, a front and rear pointer. So as we have seen in the previous case, we have been using only one pointer, one rear pointer. Now we understood the drawback of rear pointer also. Understood the drawback. So let's.
Oh, sorry for the interruption. So we have seen how to implement queue using array using only one pointer, a rear pointer. Now let's see how to implement queue using the same array and using two pointers. We have seen the drawback also, the delete operation was taking order of n time. Now let's try to implement the same queue using two pointers, but the insert, both the insert and delete operations are going to take only order of one or constant time. We have two pointers, front and rear, both are pointing to minus one in the beginning. Initially, both were pointing to minus one position. So there are no elements. So the queue empty condition is very clear now. If both front and rear are pointing to minus one, the queue is empty. Initially, front is equal to rear is equal to minus one. So we are assuming that queue is empty. Now let's say we have inserted some of the elements. 7, 15, 8, 6 and 2 were inserted. The rear is pointing to 4 now. Yeah, rear is pointing to this position. But front is again pointing to minus 1. No elements are getting are already serviced. No elements are are deleted. The first element that need to be deleted is 7. So this is the present state of the queue. Now we'll see how if you delete some of the elements, what will happen? You have deleted 7 and 15, and this is the state of the queue. So this element is, this position is blank, this position is blank. Now the front is pointing here and rear is pointing fourth position. So front is pointing one position back from the from the next element that will get deleted. Rear is pointing to the last element. That is how the queue is implemented. Front will be pointing to one, means there is element at the second position. Rear is pointing to four, means the fourth position is having the last element. So you have, if we have front equal to 1 and rear is equal to 4, you have 4 minus 1, 3 number of elements in your queue. So the deletion operation will take, will happen like this. You increment your front, front will be pointing here, then you delete it. So once you increment your front, the meaning is that you have element up to here, that's it. If the front was pointing, for example, in the previous case, the front was pointing to minus one, means you have element up to zero. Now you have a front is pointing to one, means you have element up to two. So if front is pointing to two, means you have element up to three, or four minus three, you have, four minus two, you have two elements in the queue. Now this is the condition if you have deleted all the elements. Now front is pointing to 4 and rear is also pointing to 4. You have deleted all the elements. For example, in the previous slide, you have deleted this element. Now the front will be pointing to here. You have deleted this element. Front will be pointing to here. So what will happen is, you can say front and rear are pointing to 4. So number of elements in the queue is 4 minus 4 is 0. So front is equal to 4 and rear equal to 4. 4 minus 4 equal to 0. So there are no elements in the queue. So Q queue empty condition is this friend equal to rear. Previously also we have set it as friend, initially we have set it as friend equal to rear equal to minus 1. In that state also you can say queue is empty. Whatever friend equal to rear means queue is empty. You can see some other implementation where instead of friend pointing one position back than the last element, friend will be pointing to the front element and rear will be pointing to the rear element. At that point of time, if friend equal to rear, you will have one element at this position. Means that you delete this element also, then friend will go this side. In that case, the QMT condition is front equal to or front is greater than rear. That condition you need to check. You can see this sort of an implementation in some of the textbooks, but I prefer to use our previous notation where this is valid in the case of front equal to rear equal to minus 1 or in the case of front equal to in any place you just need to check front equal to rear, that's it. Otherwise you will have to check front is greater than or equal to rear, front is greater than rear or the initial condition. Both the conditions you need to check for QMT. Now what will be the condition for Q full? Q full is nothing. Q full is the condition where the rear has reached the last position. You have a Q of size 7. You have inserted 7 elements. Means that the Q is full. You don't bother about these vacant positions. These positions are vacant because you have only 7 tickets with you and this counter person is selling some ticket. Then the first 7 person those who came in the queue, they only will get tickets, that's it. But these two persons already bought their tickets, that's why these two are vacant. Now the next person who will get the ticket is this, next person will get is this and so on. So rear is equal to 6 means another person has come, P. This person will not get service because he is not in the, he cannot be accommodated in the queue because the size of the queue is 7. So if the rear is equal to 6 or 7 minus 1, the size minus 1, that is the queue full condition, that's it. So as per our discussion, what we have seen is initially the front equal to rear equal to minus 1, that's how we have set it. Then we have seen how, what is the queue empty condition in Q full condition. Now let's see the actual implementation by using array. We'll create a structure with these many values. Struct Q. You should have these values. You should have a friend pointer, rear pointer, and a size variable. Then you should have an array of integers. I'm talking about integer Q. So this contains a size, for example, size is equal to 7, then friend is pointing to minus 1, rear is also pointing to minus 1, then you have an array Q. So a Q is having these many properties, then this array. So these values will be inserted, will be available in the stack section of the memory. These values will be available in the heap section of the memory. Once you read the size of the Q, you will dynamically create this array. That's how I say that this is going to be in the heap section of the memory. So this is the structure Q. You have size, front, rear, and then an array. This array. This array is of size 7. Let's see how you create it. You ask enter the size of the Q. You read it as 7. Then size will be inserted here. Q1 dot size, then you read, you directly say front equal to minus 1 and rear equal to minus 1 because initially the queue is empty. Then you allocate that much amount of memory. You need to store some 7 integers, malloc Q1 dot size into size of int. So if integer is taking 2 bytes, then 7 into 2, 14 bytes. If integer is taking 4 bytes, 4 into, that depends upon the system's implementation. So this is available in the, this is written in the main function. You create a you declare a structure of type Q1, then Q1's size is read, Q1's front and rear pointers are set, then that much memory is allocated. Now you can directly call insert operation and delete operation on top of this structure. This is your NQ operation. You are going to insert a value X onto it. Before inserting, you need to check whether the queue is full or not. And like that, before deleting an element, you need to check whether the queue is empty or not. That's it. So if we have already seen the queue full and queue empty conditions, you just write it as program code. That's it. If Q1 pointer rear, if rear is pointing to the last value, if Q1 pointer rear is equal to 6, then your queue is full. Otherwise, if Q1 pointer is pointing to 4, you have two more positions to insert. So if Q1 is, for example, if Q1 presently, if Q1 is pointer rear is -1, so this condition is false. Now you insert X. X is inserted here. So Q1 pointer rear ++ means it will be incremented to a value 0, and you insert X here. Once again, you call insert Y, then this will be incremented to 1, and insert Y here. Once again, you call and so on. You reach here, Z. Now this condition is true, then it will say Q is full. So that's it. An NQ operation, there is nothing. We have insert operation. It's just an insert a value X onto your queue. Before inserting, you need to check whether your queue is full or not. This is the queue full condition. That's it. If the queue is not full, you insert it in the proper space by incrementing your rear pointer. So always you remember that your insertion onto the queue is will happen at the rear end, and the deletion is going to happen from the front end. Now we'll see the DQ operation. Let's say you have elements like this. Your queue is having size equal to 7. Front is pointing to 1, this position. Rear is pointing to 4. Front is equal to 1 means you have elements from 2. 3 and up to 4. That's it. You have 4 minus 1 equal to 3 elements. You have 8, 6 and 2, 3 elements in the queue. So a delete operation is going to return the integer that is getting deleted. If you call a delete operation at this scenario, you should get this value 8. So before deleting an element from a queue, you should check whether the queue is empty or not. We have already seen how to check whether the queue is empty or not. The condition is queue front equal to rear. If front and rear both are pointing to the same value, there is, for example, if the front is also pointing to a value 4, means 4 minus 4, there are no elements in the queue. Or the initial condition, if front equal to -1 and rear equal to -1. In that case also, in that situation also, front and rear are same. So this queue empty condition is true. Otherwise, you just increment front previously pointing to 1. You increment front equal to 2. So front has reached here. Now X equal to Q of front. So you'll get this value 8. Return that value. Now front is pointing here. You have not actually removed this element from your array, but by means of an internal adjustment, you say that you have element from 3 only. You don't have an element here in your queue data structure. You don't have this element. Like this, you have elements in these places I have not shown, but these elements, we are not replacing it with something else. We are just avoiding these elements and saying that you don't have elements here. If you delete this, you say that there is no element at this position. You have element from the third position only. If you delete this also, the pointer will be pointing here, front pointer will be pointing here, and you say that there is no element here. If you delete this one again, this one also, front will be pointing here. So front and rear both are pointing into the same position. So there is no element. Actually, there are elements in the array. Inside the memory, there are elements in the array. But we say that according to the implementation of front and rear, we say that there are no elements. So that's all about the queue data structure. So today what we have seen is the queue data structure and its abstract data type. Then we have seen implementation of queue using arrays. We have seen two types of implementation. One was using one by using a single pointer, only by using a rear pointer. But in that we have seen that there is a drawback in the case of deletion operation. The deletion operation was time consuming. If the size of the queue is very large, then that implementation is not at all going to be efficient. So we have gone with another implementation where we have two pointers, a front and rear pointer. In that case, you can see that both the NQ and DQ operation, in this operation there are no looping statements, and in this operation also there are no looping statements. So both the operations are going to take only constant time or order of one time. We'll talk about this time complexity and how to calculate the time complexity of an algorithm while discussing our first module topics. Thank you.